We're doing a randomized trial comparing two different therapies for premature babies with inguinal hernia to determine which of these existing therapies is safest.
So no one really knows if one option is better than the other. That's why we need to do the study.
So an inguinal hernia is an abnormal condition that is very common in premature babies. And an inguinal hernia is an extension of a sac called the peritoneum that is inside your abdomen. And the purpose of the peritoneum is to make sure that abdominal contents such as intestine, ovaries, and other organs all stay within the abdominal cavity. So an inguinal hernia is an abnormal connection of that sac called the peritoneum, which connects to the scrotum in boys or the labia in girls. And the problem with that is when you have that abnormal connection, which is an inguinal hernia, it allows intra-abdominal content, such as intestine, most commonly, it allows those contents to go through the connection down into the groin, and that can cause problems.
So the first option is to repair your baby's hernia when your baby is still in the NICU. So when he or she reaches what we call term equivalent age, that means the age at which he or she was supposed to be born. The other option is to repair the hernia at 55 weeks corrected age. And that just means a few months after your baby was supposed to be born, after he or she has already left the NICU.
Surgeons and neonatologists don't know now, because it's not been studied, which of those two approaches is better. Again, neither one is experimental. There are some children's hospitals that would only do one. So for example, some children's hospitals would do all inguinal hernia repairs before the babies go home. There are other well-known children's hospitals that would never do that and that would always repair the hernias after some waiting period after discharge. And at a lot of hospitals, some surgeons pick one, some pick the other, and so there's a variability. So again, as of now, surgeons and neonatologists don't know which is better, which is the whole purpose of this study.
There is no cost to be in this study. We will be collecting data about your baby. The information that we'll be collecting includes details about their hernia, any treatments and medications they've received.
We feel like there's a certain group of adverse events that occur early, and there's a different set of adverse events that might occur late. We expect similar numbers of events in either group, and that's really the purpose of the study, is to try and figure out, whether early or late hernia repair is associated with fewer of those events. Children with inguinal hernia always need to have the inguinal hernia repaired, and this is different than in adults. There are some reports that are becoming available that in adults, especially in the elderly, perhaps inguinal hernia repair might not be needed, and in fact observation could be the treatment. In babies, however, with such a long time span, we feel certain between pediatric surgeons and neonatologists now that the inguinal hernia really does need to be repaired. And again, it's mainly because of the possibility of abdominal contents becoming stuck in the hernia, and that can not only injure those organs but could also injure adjacent structures.
Their surgical information when they get their hernia repaired, and we'll be following their recovery after the surgery through 10 months after enrollment.